Hello students, today we are going to learn the topic reproduction in animals. Yes, in our class 7 we have studied about reproduction in plants. Yes, right children? So what is reproduction? Reproduction is the production of offsprings by the living organisms. So this is a process like any other process, basic processes which are taking place in our bodies, like respiration, digestion, excretion, like that. So reproduction is also one of the basic process taking place in the living organisms for producing the offsprings. So this is a process for the continuation of the generations or the continuation of the species. So here we have two different types of animals depending upon the production of the offsprings. What are they? See here, oviparous animals and viviparous animals. So what are oviparous animals? So the animals which are going to lay the eggs are going to hatch and they will produce the offspring. So like this, the animals which are laying the eggs, those are called as oviparous animals. For example, like hen, snake, lizard, different types of birds, they are going to lay the eggs. After that, they are going to hatch and they are going to produce the little ones. So this type of animals are called as oviparous animals. Next, what are viviparous animals? So the animals which are giving directly birth to the young ones. So that type of animals are called as viviparous animals. Like examples, cow, goat, sheep, human beings. So these are the animals which directly give birth to the young ones. So how can we differentiate the oviparous animals and viviparous animals? So there are certain distinguishing characters or the characteristic features whereby by observing them we can identify that whether it is a oviparous animal or a viviparous animal. So those characters now we are going to discuss. What are they? See children, external ears. External ears, the presence of external ears, and the epidermal hair, the hair present on the epidermis, that is the skin. So these two are the characteristic features of the viviparous animals. If they are present, external ears and epidermal hair, then they are viviparous animal. So in oviparous animal, they are absent. External ears and epidermal hair are absent in oviparous animals. In case of viviparous animal, you can observe external ears and epidermal hair are present. So in the class 7, we have seen the reproduction in plants, where we have seen two different modes of reproduction taking place in plants, like asexual mode of reproduction and sexual mode of reproduction. So what is asexual mode of reproduction? Where there is no involvement of the male and the female organisms. So directly, like vegetative parts, root, stem and leaf giving rise to a new plant, then it is called asexual reproduction. If at all male and female organisms are involved and taking part in the process of reproduction, then it is called as sexual reproduction. We have seen in plants, flower is the reproductive part of the plant, where we can see the male and female parts, and if they are fused to form the zygote, and the zygote giving rise to the through different steps and formation of a new plant is taking place, then it is called sexual reproduction. Now we are going to see different modes of reproduction in animals. So in our surroundings we see different types of animals, male and female. But here in lower animals, that is in microorganisms, we cannot differentiate the male and female organisms. So these type of organisms, the lower animals, they undergo asexual mode of reproduction. So here are two different types of examples where they are undergoing asexual mode of reproduction. One is budding in Hydra and binary fission in amoeba. Now we'll see how it is taking place. So firstly, we'll see budding in Hydra. So first of all, the Hydra, it is a microscopic animal where it has a body and you can see the tentacles are present. From the side of the body, a small bulge develops. So this bulge, it is called as a bud. It enlarges and increases in size and started developing the tentacles around it. And after some time, it develops into, or it breaks here. The bud breaks over here and forms two different organisms. So this type of process of reproduction is called budding. Next we'll see binary fission in amoeba. Amoeba, it is irregular in shape. So this amoeba, it contains the nuclei at its center. So it increases the nuclei. Firstly, the nuclei increases in size into two and it forms two different nuclei. So a small incision or a fission develops in between the organism and the fission increases more and the two nuclei enters into two different parts of the amoeba. And in the last step, what will happen? Along with the nuclei, the cytoplasm will also divides into two and two daughter amoebas will be formed with the cytoplasm and nuclei. So an amoeba is converting into or dividing into two amoebae. Hence it is known as binary fission. So this is the process of asexual reproduction taking place in Hydra and amoeba. So now we'll see the male reproductive system. They are also present in the abdomen of the male organism. So here we can see the different parts in the male reproductive system where the egg-shaped testes are present, a pair of testes, and they are connected to the seminal duct. The sperms are produced in the testes. Through the seminal ducts, they enter into the penis and they will be ejaculated out. So, the sperm, millions of sperms are produced in the testes. They are microscopic in nature and they are single celled. So, the human sperm, it consists of the head, middle piece and tail. Nucleus is present in the head and mitochondria, which is present in the middle piece, is giving the energy for the sperm to travel. So, tail will help in the movement of the sperm. Now, we will see the female reproductive system. So, it is present in the abdominal part. This is the abdominal part of our body where the reproductive system is present in this region below the navel of the female organisms. So this female reproductive system, it consists of mainly three different parts. The oviduct, these are the oviducts on either side. They are also called as fallopian tubes. And two ovaries, one on either side, and they will release the ovum. From this ovary, the ovum will be released through the fallopian tube into the uterus. So this is the uterus, is the part where the embryo will develop, and the after formation of the zygote onto the walls of the uterus, the embryo is going to attach to this and it will develop into the fetus. Now we'll see the sexual mode of reproduction. See, what is sexual mode of reproduction? Here, the fusion of the male reproductive cell with the female reproductive cell is called as a sexual mode of reproduction. So generally in our surroundings we'll see animals and human beings, male and female, differently. So here the reproductive cell from the male and the reproductive cell from the female fuse to form a zygote. So here we'll see the flow chart how the fusion of the gametes is taking place. So from the male, sperm is a reproductive cell, and from the female, ovum is the reproductive cell. These together, the sperm and the ovum fuse to form the zygote. The process of formation of the zygote is nothing but fertilization. So here the union of the sperm and ovum will form the zygote. This process is called as fertilization. In some animals, the fertilization process takes place inside the body of the female animal or the organism, like for example insects and lizard, human beings. So there occurs internal fertilization, and in some animals the fertilization takes place outside the body of any organism. For example, like frogs, there takes place external fertilization. So here, after the formation of the zygote, this zygote, one of the cell, it is obtained from the male and the other from the female. So here it is in diploid state, and it is forming a single cell by the combination of the two different cells. It is forming a single cell, but it is in the diploid state. That means the chromosomal set is diploid in nature. So after the formation of the zygote, it undergoes division of cells, takes place in the body of the organism, and forms into embryo. Embryo, after some days of development, it converts into fetus. Here in the fetus, there occurs all the organs, and different body parts will be distinct so that we can see it. So this fetus, after completion of the gestation period is nothing but simply pregnancy period. In human beings, it is from 270 to 280 days. Simply, it is of 9 months where the formation of the baby takes place. That is, the fetus takes place in the mother's womb. This period is called as the pregnancy period. So, after completion of this period, of the gestation period, the baby is undergoing its birth. So, here, this process is called as sexual reproduction. So we have seen the male and female reproductive system. So, but in some animals, there occurs male and female reproductive in organs in the same animal. For example, like earthworms. So they will carry out the reproductive organs. Both male and female will be carried by single organisms. That type of animals are called as hermaphrodite animals or bisexual animals. Yes, now we'll see the cloning method. What is cloning? See, we'll see the story of Dolly. So this was the first animal which was produced by cloning. So cloning is a process of production of an exact copy of a cell, a living part, or completely an organism. So simply we can call it a Xerox copy of a cell, a living part, or any organism is nothing but cloning. So this was first, it took birth on 5th July 1996. So what was done actually? So Ann Wilmot and his colleagues in Roslin Institute in Scotland, they developed the Dolly. So here occurred, like in from the female Finn Dorset sheep, they have taken the cell of the Finn dorset sheep and removed from the mammary gland. They have taken the cell and removed the nucleus. And from the Scottish blackface, this is also one of the sheep, they have taken the egg of it and removed the nucleus from it. So from Finn dorset sheep they have taken the nucleus, and from the Scottish blackface they have taken the egg and removed the nucleus. So this nucleus of the Finn dorset sheep they inoculated into the Scottish blackface sheep, and normally it has undergone the sexual mode of reproduction and it has given birth to Dolly, which has shown all the features of the Finn dorset sheep, because it was the nucleus of the Finn dorset sheep. So it has shown all the features of the Finn dorset sheep. But unfortunately, on 14th February 2003, the Dolly died due to some lung disease. From then, the scientists are doing so many experiments for producing new animals by the process of cloning. And there are other artificial reproductive methods also. You might have heard like test tube babies. What are test tube babies? Are they grown in the test tubes? Can any animal or organism or any human being can be grown in the test tube? No. Simply called these test tubes, they due to some problems faced by the male and female. Like in the male, the sperm count may be less or they may be producing defective sperms. So the sperm is the reproductive cell from the male organisms, and ovum, it is the egg from the female organism. They are going to collect the freshly released sperms from the male and ovum from the female animals, and they will be inoculated inside the test tube grown together, so that fusion takes place between male and female. After zygote formation, they will be normally incorporated into the uterus of the female animal, so that it develops normally in the female and it gives the male, female animal or the human being will develop the baby in her womb and give birth to the young one. So this is nothing but test tube babies. So the word, it may be misleading, test tube babies, but it is simply just till the fusion of the male and female they have done in the test tube, or simply this can be called as in vitro fertilization. As we have seen earlier, internal fertilization, external fertilization, and here this is taking place in the test tube, hence it is called as in vitro fertilization. So in this way, for the production, for the continuation of the generations, or the for the continuation of the species, any animal, plant, or the human being has to produce their offsprings. So this is all about reproduction.